The Belt Road Initiative is basically one of the largest infrastructure development projects that have been undertaken in recent history. It covers more than 60 countries and has an investment pipeline of more than $1 trillion. Even though the high-level numbers are interesting, there are a number of challenges in executing these projects. I know this personally as a supplier of materials in Sri Lanka. One of the biggest challenges we face is to find working capital for our daily operations and expansions. Chinese contractors, when they move on to these countries, they need to overcome language barriers and access local contractors. And on different parts of the world, especially in Hong Kong and China, there are investors who want to get exposure to Belt Road projects, but there are limited product offerings in the market. So what is our solution? First and foremost, we are an online marketplace between contractors and suppliers. Based on these trade confirmations, we also have a peer-to-peer invoice discounting platform. So, since our launch in Sri Lanka, we have managed to get on board 4 very large Chinese state-owned enterprises. We've also been referred to our first client in Bangladesh who's doing a highway project. We have more than 10 registered suppliers and 2 funders who have committed to purchase invoices up to $600,000. Sri Lanka was our pilot market and it still is. These 4 projects alone have an investment of $4.7 billion. Roughly 30% of that converts into local procurements of basic rock, sand, and transportation materials. So, me and my co-founder do not come from a technical background, so we've engaged Virtusa Polaris, a NASDAQ-listed tech company, to help us go to market. Standard Chartered Bank has come on board as our co-banker. We are talking to them on API integration to completely automate the backend. There is cross-border financing, so therefore some regulatory structures need to be cleared. We have engaged the international law firm and their local partner to get the legal setup cleared. We've also covered 3 events before coming to Istanbul. In terms of revenue, how do we make money? We make commissions of all the invoices that go through our platform. Going forward, we also want to take a servicing fee from our funders. Large international banks do finance contractors, and there are marketplaces for SME financing, but we are the only company right now who are bridging these 2 concepts together. This is our founding team. We have some banking and trading experiences. We are backed by an advisory board, and we are looking for like-minded investors to join our journey. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Well done. They'll take it from you. Big market.